वर्ल्ड नेचर कंजर्वेशन डे ऑब्जर्व्ड ऑन 28 जुलाई एवरी ईयर acknowledges that a healthy environment is the foundation for a stable and healthy society. So, now what does conservation mean? Conservation is basically the protection of the natural world by not allowing some things to be wasted, damaged or destroyed and by using the earth's resources wisely so that those resources last for much longer period of time. Longer lasting of Earth's resources means the longer existence of life on the planet. Earth's natural resources include air, water, minerals, plants, soil, and wildlife. Conservation basically means the protection of these resources for future generations. So, in order to conserve these resources, diversity of ecosystem should be maintained. Think of if all the giraffes are extinct from the earth. What will happen? The animals like lions and hyenas will be affected as they feed on giraffes. Okay, now we may claim that they can eat other animals. Giraffe is not so important. But think of the huge and tall trees whose leaves are unreachable by other herbivores. Who will eat them? Giraffe does that? This is just an example. Each life has something to contribute. Hence, the diversity in ecosystem is really essential. If one is affected, the whole system, including humans, are affected. There are several threats like deforestation, illegal wildlife poaching for trade, excessive pollution, use of chemicals and plastics, and the overgrowing human population. Earth has provided us with basic life sustaining necessities like air, water, soil, minerals, food, trees, animals, and even the microbes. That is why life exists on Earth and in no other planet. We should keep the nature clean and healthy and use these resources as wisely. As quoted by Mahatma Gandhi, Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, but not every man's greed. The human overpopulation has caused a decline in wildlife population. This is because more land and its resources are occupied by the mankind. Industrial development has put a severe impact on the air, water and soil. Resulting to high pollution, this has also resulted to an increase in Earth's temperature causing global warming. Snow in the mountainous regions is melting rapidly. Think of how will the cold area species survive there. Deforestation has been a major reason of habitat loss for the wildlife. This gives rise to more natural disaster. And now let's not talk about disaster causing diseases. We are already going through the coronavirus pandemic. Now it is clear that conservation of the nature is very, very important. But how can we do that? First thing first, a limit on deforestation and industrial pollution is necessary. The government and the higher authorities should make sure that none crosses the limit. If done, should be severely punished and fined. Population control should be initiated. Family planning and women education can make it possible to some extent. As we all general people can put our part to conserve and preserve the planet. Most importantly, be wise in utilizing the resources. We should not waste water as every drop counts. Reusing water is possible in every household. Do as much as you can. We can also preserve rainwater, the excellent source. We can grow vegetables and fruits in our own home. In case of no space, we can easily do something in kitchen, balconies and terrace. Use of bicycle or even walking on short distance can keep us as well as our environment healthy. In case of moving to large distances, we can use public transport if possible. Smoking is one major factor of pollution both in air and on land, as the remains seep into the soil and waterways. They even pollute our lungs and the whole body. Reuse and recycle of things that are no more in use can also make a difference. Instead of throwing them away in the dustbin, such items can either be subjected to reusing or for recycling. For example, mini jars and empty containers can be reused in household to either store other food items or for decoration. Paper, cloths, and degradable glass and plastic can be recycled. Use of plastic should be discouraged and we should use cloth or paper bags instead. Cloth bags are the best as they can easily be washed and reused again and again. They are even easy to make by some not needed clothes. My granny used to do that. Amazingly inspiring. A target of planting and treasuring the trees can also be beneficial. Trees release oxygen and absorb carbon dioxide. Moreover, they help in maintaining a pleasant temperature and even protect the planet from natural disasters like floods and earthquakes. Last but not the least, a day is not enough for the conservation of the environment. As general people, each day we should make our habit and feel our responsibility to protect, clean and conserve the environment. It's for our betterment that we do so. Do you feel the same that I do? If yes, then take a pledge today to avoid wasting water or anything you can do as your part to conserve the environment. I pledge not to get engaged in any sort of smoking or drug abusing activities. Also, I will not waste food and water at all. I will eat and drink only as much as I need. Help me spread this video as much as you can. Thank you.